to Star from back at one more again. I hope you are doing fabulous on this sensational Sunday. If this is your first time coming to my channel, welcome. Namaste, love and light to you. And please like and subscribe. Hit that notification button on that side and hit the bell so you know when I'm able to upload my next video. If you are returning, thank you for the support, love and light and blessings to you, and namaste. Today my video is about Twin Flames 101. Never give people keys to your happiness. Guys, I'm feeling so splendiferous. I'm doing good. Yes, I went silly mode on y'all. I'm feeling splendiferous. Right now I'm listening to Art of Noise. This is a jam from way back in the day. I think it was made in like 1988 or something like that. I don't remember. I gotta look it up. But it's just a whole bunch of beats put together. I put it on one of my videos probably a couple weeks back. But I always loved it because it's just like, I used to fall asleep to it. It's 19 minutes long. If you can find it on the thing, Art of Noise, Moments of Love. And I'm feeling like this. I feel love all around me. I mean, even though if you're not even with nobody, it feels so good. Even not have a man in my life to feel good. It be happy. It didn't have to do with money. It didn't have to do with no man. Or no job. It's me being happy because it's me. You know, I was talking to you guys just on my last video, recognizing this, because I was really going through some emotional and mental abuse. And a lot of the stuff I created on my own because I would be a hothead. And sometimes I'll create stuff, and half the time it went in beer. But it was just me and my overthinking, me and my negative thoughts. Because it's just like I had so many blessings around me. It could be little, it could be actually big. But it wasn't the ones that I was like looking for. And it seemed like I wasn't being grateful for the universe or what they were presenting me. So it was like you have to be happy for what we have. You know, and I say that in all my videos. And it's because we do that. We will complain. We will complain about our job. We will complain about our house, our clothes, our food. You know, what we drive in. You know, what neighborhood we live in. It's just the fact that we be happy with the house. It might not be an exact neighborhood you want to be in, but I understand there could be some circumstances, like, you know, safety reasons, or just, you know, bad neighborhood shootings or whatever. I understand that. But it's just the fact is, when you're in a decent neighborhood, and it might not be where you want it to be, just be grateful. It's just like, I had to really be grateful of everything, like, everything. Just the little small things that I'm getting right now. And it's just like, when I start looking at it in a bigger perspective and stop actually looking at it, like, as what it is, and look at it outside of the box, like, look at so much of what you're learning from the experience that you're going through, and appreciate all the things that comes along with it. You know, it might be aggravating, it might be irritating, it might be like a bad toenail, you know, hangnail or something like that. You know, something like that. And it's just like, we gotta learn to be happy, learn to love ourselves, learn to love yourself amongst all the craziness. You know, all people don't, you know, people sometimes recognize it's just like everything is, it's like it's already played out, and we're all following suit on the roles we need to play to the game of life, basically. It's like the game of life. And it's just, I don't know why lately I've been, every time I make a video, it's like, it's right nostril. And that's a good thing. They say you're going to get visitors when that happens. Because my nose is starting itching like crazy. If it ain't that, it's my right foot. And that says you're on a new path. And that's a good thing, too. But it's like when I say that was 421. But it's just to know that the situation I'm in right now is not final. And I had to look at it that way. And it's just like when we let go of things, you start feeling better. Your frequency goes up. You don't feel tired. You might even feel youthful, because it's like now I don't even feel 40. I don't even know what 40 feels like, because I'll still be dancing and talking sometimes. And it just feels like I have an old soul, but I'm young at heart.
and I feel that way. Because it's just like some people say, well, you don't look like you're 40 years old.
Yeah.
You know, and I really don't feel it. There's sometimes I tell my age if I start missing music or television shows or something like that. But nah, it just feels really good to actually let go of everything and just like, you know what? Just worry about you and being happy. Because you only get one life. There's just so many people are having these diseases they're trying to find cures for and fight off. And I mean, I pray for everybody who, you know, I see it, you know, fat and fighting cancer, epilepsy, you know, having to deal with epilepsy for like 6 or 7 months was just, I'm just blessed that I only have to have that experience just for that time, and I haven't had it in like 10 years since then. So, you know, it's just so many things I'm grateful for that I've experienced, and I can actually look at it, and it's just like, I wouldn't have made it a lot of times through the things I made it through. It's just like, yeah, you know, I wish I would have told my dad my name when, you know, he got on the phone and thought it was, you know, I was my stepmom, and it was actually me. You know, I wish I would have said something, but it's just like, you know, you can't change the past, just accept for what it is, you know, even though I lost my father in the process. But I gained so much from him, and it feels so good, and just to know, it's just, I'm so close to being home, it's not even funny, it's just not even funny, and I know this was going to be my little piece to get me home, because I don't let go of the things with my family. I can, even though you can talk about something that tragically happened to you, and it's not the fact you can say something happened to you, and people look at you like, dang, it didn't affect you at all. And it's not the fact that it didn't affect you, it's just the fact is you didn't let it define you. You healed from it, you experienced from it, you're able to tell your story like, yeah, this happened to me. But I've learned so much from this experience. And it's just like, I wouldn't wish this on my worst enemy, I really would, because it's just a lot that I had to deal with. And it was a lot that I had to heal from, because I was just not in a good place. I was in a very dark place. And I let a lot of people have a key to my happiness, and I blamed them for a lot of things, even though, I mean, I could blame them, but it was just a lot of stuff. It was, I can say, because my reactions or way I responded to or the path I chose to take from it. So I can admit, you know, my faults on the things that I've done. So it's just like, you know, like I was watching the movie Flatliners, and it was basically saying the same thing. I'm not going to tell the ending, but it's just basically you forgiving yourself, admit to your responsibilities, remember to own up to the part that you played. And I had to do that. And when I own up to the part that I played, and basically, like me doing, I do categorize and calculate everything from moment to moment, I just said okay. It was just okay. When you tell people how you truly feel, there can never be no misunderstanding. So it's just like when their feelings are hurt, they can't get mad at anything if you told them the truth in the first place. So, you know, and if it you know, my happiness hurts somebody, I'm sorry, but I'm going to live my life. I'm going to be happy. Because it's just like everybody, you're not going to be able to make everybody happy. You're not going to be able to please everybody. But as long as you know, you're not going out there trying to hurt anybody and, you know, by making yourself happy, by all means, go ahead and do it. So it's just like, well, now somebody can ask me if I'm good, I'm great. You know, I'm actually great. Even though I might not have much, I'm grateful for every little thing, every nook and cranny I got. You know, because there's things that we complain about every day. It could be where we live, how much is in our bank account, the job or car, you know, even our house or the furniture we have. Even though we might not be the best furniture in the world, it might not be the prettiest couch, but at least you got a couch to sit on. You know what I'm saying? You just keep that raggedy daggone thing, and we be able to get it up. But then it's just, you know, there's some people that have, you know, good luck where they only have to worry about suffering. So, hold on, guys. Those are my friends. My bad, y'all. But still, don't let me give nobody key to your happiness. You be happy for you. You live your life. But it's just like, I know after all this, there ain't gonna be some happy people in the world, but you know what? Hey, I have to live my life. I know I'll be happy because I'll be with my family. And it's just sometimes I'll get to that overthinking.
and think about all the negative things that I've been through. And sometimes it can get stagnant and make me stuck. So I had to get myself out of that. Because it's just like, if I'm going to be putting these videos out, this is like something I really want to do. It's like I was telling a friend of mine the other day, this is something I really want to do. I'm going to make a career of this because it makes me feel good by making these videos. And I see the side effect of what I'm getting back, you know, the feedback I'm getting back that I know is good. So I can't even remember the last time I got a negative comment. I can't remember the last time I got a negative comment. So I know I'm on the right path and I know I'm doing the right thing. So it's just like I have so much to be grateful for, even though I'm like not with my family or whatever. I mean, I'm living, I'm above ground. It's just like I got power. It's just like I got my precious computer on my phone, you know, able to listen to music, able to see the birds out. It's just so much to be grateful for. There's some people that can't hear, there's some people that can't see, and we're able to get up in the morning and be worried about, oh, you know, what we're going to do today. You know, even though we got a whole, you know, refrigerator full of food, we complain about it. And there's some people trying to rub two sticks together trying to figure out what they don't eat today. So I try to be grateful for everything that I'm doing. But I'm not going to hold you guys up with for real. Do not let nobody have peace for your happiness. Be happy. Love yourself. Don't be hard on yourself. And when you are hard on yourself, you got to forgive yourself. Forgive yourself first. And let go of the rest. Your karma and your universe deal with us. We got you. And I'll talk to you later. Peace. And be wild. Like and subscribe, hit that notification button if I ain't tell you that, because I done told y'all I made this video about 4 or 5 times, so I don't know if I said that at the end. So like and subscribe, hit that bell, and you'll know when the next time I'm about to upload my next video. Love and light, namaste to you. Peace and be wild. And I pray for you guys, pray for others, and pass on love. Bye.